$149 a month.
Lease a double cab silver.
Lease for just $129 a month.
Car leasing is bigger than ever, making up more than 30% of the U.S. automotive market.
If you like being in new cars most of the time, leasing is probably for you.
Philip Reed is the autos writer for NerdWallet.com. He says leasing's a great option for people who use their cars for work and who like the latest tech, such as EVs.
Electric cars are heavily subsidized, and they also are probably going to be outdated in a few years, so always lease an electric car.
Just like buying, you need to fight for your best deal. First, design a lease that works for you, starting with the term.
Never lease for longer than 3 years, because if you do, you'll be outside of the warranty that comes with the car.
So don't pay for something that's already included. And cap the amount you put down at signing.
Put down maybe just $1,000 for drive-off fees. That puts your money less at risk, and it frees it up for cash flow, which is one of the benefits of leasing.
And know how much you drive so you get enough mileage. The penalties can be a killer. Next, get online and shop the specials.
If you go to the manufacturer's websites under the specials, you can sometimes find some really amazing offers, low monthly payments, and sometimes zero drive-off fees.
While you're online, head to the lease forums at Edmunds.com and LeaseHacker.com. That's hacker without the E.
You'll find valuable information about interest rates, contacts at dealerships, and gain really powerful negotiating information.
Negotiating is crucial because
there's really only one significant figure that can be negotiated in the lease, and that's the value of the car.
That means you need to shop as if you're buying.
What you want to do is get as close to or below invoice as possible, because this will greatly reduce your monthly payment.
And forget about trying to play Jedi mind tricks on a salesman. You can probably get a better deal from your couch.
If you go through the internet, you're dealing with a salesperson who's used to giving information remotely. They're not afraid to give out solid figures, and very often those figures are a lot lower than if you showed up in person.
And you can play those numbers against the internet sales departments at other dealerships. Finally, when you've negotiated your best price, remember to keep the deal clean, because dealerships love to tack on gobbledygook.
Understand all the fees that are being included. Ask for those fees to be listed up front before you agree to the deal.
If the dealer can't justify the line item, have it removed or threaten to walk. You can get a great deal on a lease, but keep in mind that in the long term, it's not the cheapest way to drive.
If you want to save the most money, it's probably good to buy a car and drive it until the wheels fall off.
Saving dough when you drive, at the top of the list.